With a win on Monday against the Devils, the Hawks headed into the Christmas break with 2 points in their stockings, highlighted by yet another five-goal performance. Tonight, they'll face an Avalanche team that is looking up at Chicago in the division, but in their first meeting, they limited the Hawks' offense to just one goal. Tonight, Kane and the boys will be looking to open up the floodgates as a Central showdown begins next from the West Side. Center after a short Christmas getaway. The Chicago Blackhawks back at it. This is a place where they have compiled the third highest home point total in the league. And tonight they take on a team that spanked them in Denver a couple weeks back, the Colorado Avalanche. Welcome in, everybody. Pat Foley, Eddie Olczyk. Thrilled you're with us for Chicago Blackhawks hockey. And if you look at the Blackhawks scoring list, you see that Brandon Saad ranks sixth with 28 points. Real good numbers for a young guy. You want to take a look at some versatility and some of the other things he does beyond numbers.
Yeah, Pat, it is not the end result that we're going to take a look at. And points are important for a guy like Brandon Saad. But for all you young hockey players out there, look at Brandon Saad. Know what you're going to do with the puck before you get to it. Take a quick look. Here's the telestrator look. In on the forecheck. That circle there, there's the eventual goal scorer. But look at Saad. Goes in, knows what he's going to do. Now look at in front of the net. Who's in front but Andrew Shaw? Great forecheck. Great pass out to Brian Bickell. Net front presence. The Hawks with a goal. Great job there from Brandon Saad. Going to go to a Blackhawk power play. Know what you're going to do before you get to the puck. Know your role. Power play. Win a faceoff, you need some help. Here's Brandon Saad. He's going to come in behind Christopher Stieg. He makes the pass back to Brent Seabrook, and then the Hawks go D to D. Brent Seabrook to Nick Leddy. Great patience here by Leddy to take the ice, but Brandon Saad doing a little things, Pat. And I would be extremely disappointed and surprised if Brandon Saad isn't a member of Team USA come the Olympics in February 4th, Team USA.
It would be a very well-deserved position for him. Meanwhile, the Colorado Avalanche, a team with a lot of young, speedy forwards, they've given the Hawks trouble a couple of times over the last few years. Among their guys to pay attention to, their leading scorer is just 22 years old.
Yeah, Matt Duchene is one of the quicker, faster players in the National Hockey League, Pat. He has great breakaway speed, meaning if you think you're on him, he has another gear. He's on a nice scoring streak right now where he's got points in five straight games, but he has unbelievable offensive ability in small area. So being close to him, Pat, isn't good enough. Matt Duchene, one of the more exciting players in the league.
And the Avs have been pretty good on the road so far this year. So a challenge for the Blackhawks as they get back to business after a Christmas getaway. And this game features two of the last six Calder Trophy winners as rookies of the year. But Gabriel Landeskog has 24 points for Denver. Patrick Kane, 49 points, second best of the league.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise. Kindly remove all hats to honor U.S. Army Staff Sergeant Adam Thomas Urban, U.S. Marine Sergeant Christopher Renner, U.S. Army Korean War veteran Gregory Jeremar, and joint organist Frank Pellico, and soloist Jim Cornelison for the singing of our national anthem.
Stripes and bright stars.
Welcome back inside the UC, where we take a look at the Ford goaltending matchup. And that young man is making his 10th consecutive appearance tonight. In his last four decisions, 3-0-1 and only six goals against in his last four games. And by the way, his first NHL appearance ever came against this Colorado team. That was the game the Hawks got spanked. Crawford got lifted after 13 minutes. The entire Blackhawks team had a bad start. And Ronto was thrown in there for the last 46 minutes. There's J.S. Jaguar at the other end. His last game was 10 days ago. And look at that record, pretty strong, but he started the year 7-0 with only eight goals against in his first seven decisions. The officiating crew led by Mark Jonette right there, paired up with Francis Charon and the linesman Andy McElman and Brian Pancich, and we're underway on West Madison Street.
And the first period of Blackhawk hockey is brought to you by Toyota. Let's go places.
Parenteau's long one blockered away by Runta. Rebound to Hayda, putting it in behind. Well, the Avs try to pry it loose, but Sharp got to it. And a board battle here. Landeskog had it, then lost it. Good poke check there by Duncan Keith. And Taves the other way. Taves gets it in. Sharp, well covered by Hayda. And now Taves on the other side, dropped it to Seabrook. He'll go to Keith. He's going to walk and wire. And he tried to pass it in front. A shot went wide. What a pass to Taves. Well, I'm not sure he had a good look at the feed. Another long one handled here by Jaguar.
Boy, what a pass by Duncan Keith, as you made mention, Pat. Left part of your screen. There's the pass. Jonathan Taves trying to one-time this and puts it back in between the post and the net of J.S. Jaguar. Jaguar was out. I mean, he had lost his net, and look at the reaction from Jonathan Taves. Now he's going to school, Pat, up on the Jumbotron. Well, what a chance there. What a great pass from Seabrook to Keith to create that chance right off the bat.
Clearing attempt held in by Jalmerson. Versteeg from the corner. Got pushed to the deck. Puck came free to Oduya. Now Hanzus wrapped up along the boards by Duchesne. Hanzus out of the corner will then leave it. Versteeg takes a look. And had to chip it loose. Kane put it down for Hanzus. He's checked in the corner by Nate Genin. Kane tried to center. It rolled all the way to Jaguar. He's going to hang on to it. You know, Eddie, you and I had talked about this before the game tonight. This first post-Christmas game is always interesting because, and now there's an additional day added. Right. You know, now you can't play or travel on the 26th either. And Patrick Waugh's team didn't skate today. They didn't get here in time to take the morning skate. He really didn't. He's not a big fan of those things anyway. But so basically, they haven't played or been on the ice at all for the last 3 days.
Right.
So you got to expect the first couple of shifts might be a little interesting from the perspective of both teams, but certainly the Avs.
Yeah, very rarely you ever go 3+ days without skating over the course of a regular season. You always get a practice of some sort in before you would actually get back into the lineup, so it'll be interesting to see how they react here, not only short-term, but long-term throughout this game.
Here's a long reach shot not getting to the net, and Letty looks to counterattack. He's got some wheels. Letty put it in for Saad. Letty to that, the pass just jumped away from his blade. And now Bickle had a blowout in the corner. Back comes John Mitchell for Colorado. Jamie McGinn put it into the corner for Mitchell. Mitchell going to be met by Shaw, who separates him from the puck beautifully. And now it's picked up by Roosevelt. Cleared it ahead. Taves chasing in. Benoit trying to stay with him, and they come together in deep. And McLeod joins the party. He lost it to Hossa. Marian Hossa left it for Johnny Oduya. Put it to Jalmerson around a check, cutting and shooting. Good save by Jaguar. What a move by Jalmerson. Maybe his most electric stick handling sequence in his career in the offensive zone. Here's a keep to Sharp. He's going to put it across. Jalmerson broke his stick on the shot attempt. And Cleese able to get it out. Here's Taze quickly back in. Going to leave for Sharp. Back for Taze. He could not kick to the stick while being checked by Parenteau. Toews able to jam it loose to Sharp. Back to Keith. He whiffed on a pass attempt. Sharp tries to keep it in. Stasny bangs it loose. Now Seabrook. His rink wide deflecting. Kruger got to it. Scooped it high in there. Ada and Bolig crunch in deep. Then Smith came up with a puck. Left it for Brandon Bolig. And a big board battle here in the Denver end. Finally, Landeskog chipped it loose. That hit somebody in the Colorado bench, and the whistle goes.
Well, what a rush to the middle of the ice. Tyson Berry, their defenseman, Pat, made a good recovery on that opportunity for Nick Leddy, but there's Nicholas Hjalmarsson with that great movement up from the blue line in, and Hawks really moving their defensemen in and out, causing some problems for the Avalanche in their own zone. Well, besides everyone here in Chicago, we'd like to welcome those viewers tuning in tonight's game on the Comcast Network. Happy holidays to all.
They're going to move this draw outside the Colorado end. And now the draw bounced across to Berry, who's forced to turn back. Goes around to Wilson. He has a problem in the corner, nearly lost it. Then Versteega shot, missed the target, and bounced all the way out. Odu's going to turn this over. A good read by Duchesne. Put it in front. Landeskog shot. And a save by Ranta. Able to deny Nathan MacKinnon. And talking about the speed and skill of some of these Colorado forwards, MacKinnon, just 18 years old. He has been a great find for them.
Yeah, the number one pick overall from the, or for the Colorado Avalanche. And that great speed of Matt Duchesne kept that play alive off the turnover from Johnny Oduya. Key there was Antti Raanta with no rebound given up, with Duchesne standing right in front.
Mitchell wins a draw. Berry battles his way to the corner. Helm again rolled it back. Wilson's long shot never got to the goal. And a big hit at center ice by McGinn. He had Smith in his crosshairs and lowered the boom. Roosevelt the other way for Bolig. His wrist shot into the glove of Jaguar.
Well, time now for our Hyundai. What to look for this first game after the Christmas break. And anytime, Pat, you made mention of it, the time off after, you got to keep it simple. Don't try to make too many fancy plays and straight ahead. Joel Quenneville loves to use that phrase, is play straight ahead, play with pace. And that is a big key tonight against the Colorado Avalanche, who can get up and go, certainly.
Off a Shaw faceoff when it was shot wide. Now Seabrook in behind Shaw battling. It's help there from Bickle. Put it back to Keith. Good keep to Seabrook. Looking for Shaw in the middle of the ice. He was well covered, and the Avs able to get out. Arento brings it around. Now Paul Stasny, who comes in with 6 points in his last five games. He rolls this back. Here's a long shot. Bennon into the breadbasket. Then it was came loose from around some of the Hawks on it. And Shaw will put it back the other way and look for a change. Nate Bennon, there's it back into Chicago ice. Leash on Leddy. And Hossa got there to support. He put it to Roosevelt, looking back towards Hossa, but the stick of Landis, or of O'Reilly broke up the pass, and it's offside. A reminder, as you enjoy a cold one, look forward to Miller time later in the game tonight. It'll be brought to you by Miller Lite.
Hey, happy 30th birthday to Anthony Tavolino, a big Blackhawk fan.
And happy birthday to John Gorman. I got a nice letter from him, and he is a huge Olchek fan down there in Florida. All right, here's MacKinnon racing in on Hjalmarsson, trying to go rink wide. It went between a couple of teammates. O'Reilly taken away by Oduya. Helmerson helped by Oduya, who's able to jam it loose. And Tay is going to turn it over. Here's O'Reilly, a blast. Boom! Save by Ronta! And a beauty. Oh, some turnovers by the Hawks in their own end, but nothing costly yet.
Welcome back to United Center. Up at press level, I'm Tracy Myers for CSNChicago.com. Patrick Sharp would obviously love to play for Team Canada in the upcoming Olympics, and considering all Sharp's done for the Blackhawks, teams say he's worthy of that. And in our Geico quote, Duncan Keith said there's a lot of talk of who's going to make it with so many good players from Canada, but he's done everything he can in his power to show Team Canada what he can do. Pat Nutty, back to you.
Thank you, Tracy.
Mentioned there have been a few turnovers in the early stages of this game.
Yeah, and time now, partner, for a GMC professional grade saves. And there's one off the stick of Ryan O'Reilly right into the catcher's mitt of Antti Raanta. I love the positioning where he was in his crease. Bat out on top of the crease, out challenging, knowing that he saw two Avalanche players to his right in the corner. O'Reilly got the puck. Oduya lost an edge. And O'Reilly came right down there and let a big slapper go. So Raanta was able to come out and be aggressive, knowing where everybody was on the ice.
As got a draw, Wilson's long one didn't get through as Kane got to his check nicely.
That's the way to lead with the stick.
McLeod from the corner. And it taken away, and now the Hawks, Kane. Weaves back towards center, going to put it for Roosevelt. Able to get away from his check. Versteeg for Kane in deep. Back to Chris Versteeg. Now Hanzus in behind. Put it out to Letty. Brings it around here, and Versteeg battles his way out in front, put it to Kane, kicks to the stick, turns in deep. Kane hanging on. Dropped it to Letty. Trying to center, a tip pass from Versteeg, but Hanzus well covered that time by Klisch. And Kane again. What a great shift here for this line. Here's a long shot, soaked up by Jaguar. He really wants to hang on to that. His team hasn't touched the puck in 30 seconds.
Pat, we talk a lot about the Blackhawks and their defensemen being aggressive. And from our Xfinity Telestrator, here's Michael Roosevelt. This is a defenseman. The puck's over on the left-hand side. Watch his route. I mean, he's coming all the way down there. He's like a rover. He's coming down there, setting a pick, opening up some space there. He did the same thing on that last play where he stepped up there. Patrick Kane found that soft little area. Nobody in front of the net, but the Blackhawks really trying to force the Avalanche to defend in their own zone by getting the defenseman involved. And really, the scheme and the reason for that is to cause a little bit of confusion, because when you're in your own zone, the wingers have the other team's defenseman. So if they start flying down there, now there's a little bit of confusion, and that opens up space. The Blackhawk players certainly know that their defense are going to be aggressive.
Brandon Saad. Cleared it in behind. Bickel spins to his forehand. But finally had it knocked away. And Talbot beaten to it by Seabrook. Puck is held in momentarily. Finally, the Avs get out of their own end where they've spent the last shift and a half. And now Andrew Schoen does not have a point in his last five games. Cleared it in to Keith. Duncan Keith, long wrister, tip, good save, and a redirect by Jaguar. And the rebound to Johnson. Eric Johnson able to work his way into the Blackhawks' end. He gets together with Oduya. It's cleared over to the other side, and Smith couldn't advance it. Berry down low. Tyson Berry leaves it in the corner, then got it back. Berry. No lane, he put it across. Here's a Wilson centering attempt, deflecting, came back to him, he shoots. That hit his own teammate in the foot and captured by Bolig. And his dumping attempt goes out of play.
Well, the Blackhawks are giving you a chance on an authentic Blackhawks championship ring. Blackhawks Charities has launched an online raffle for a chance to win an authentic Chicago Blackhawks championship ring engraved with the winner's name. Raffle tickets can be purchased for $2 each through Friday, March the 21st. Visit ChicagoBlackhawks.com for more information.
Nathan MacKinnon. Taken away by Oduya. Now Duchesne used the official as a kind of a screen and nearly got to the front. Now tries again. Shoot. Good save by Runza down low. Rebound in behind. Oduya had a jump loose. And been a frightful first period for Johnny O so far. Now they battle on the boards and Hossa able to chip it loose. Here's Sharp in for Taves. Out of the Taves, a little stop and go, trying to get rid of O'Reilly, could not. Still centered, and Johnson broke up the play. Now Taves once more. An assist and a plus three the other night against New Jersey for the captain. And he mishandles this one. As the Avs able to get it out.
Yeah, there's one of those type of plays, Pat. You know, the Blackhawks skated this morning, but having those 3 days off and just not used to having this much time off and then jumping right back into a game.
All right, now the Avs look to move away. John Mitchell put it in there. Throws the ball, tipped it to the corner. And then comes back around this side and getting a long shot. Ooh, I'm not sure Ranta had a look at that. It just went wide. And cleared back into the Colorado zone for Steak first on it. Battling with Benoit. His pass didn't connect, and Nate Genin starts the Avalanche back. Clearing pass, a long shot from Parrotto that he attempted it to flex out of play with half the first period gone by, and we're scoreless in Chicago.
Time now for our Illinois Lottery graphic. Coach Q, former coach of the St. Louis Blues, will be in St. Louis tomorrow. First all-time, second all-time with 248 wins with the Blackhawks, and 1-2-3. He was third all-time with the Avalanche. Assistant coach there also winning a Stanley Cup. So Coach Q, two as a head coach, one as an assistant.
Yep.
He was with the Avs.
Lenny trying to go up the middle. Shaw got there and bounced it out. Oh, the Avs reorganize. Berry scoops it into Chicago territory. Lenny knew Bortolo was coming, able to one-hand it around, and Roosevelt will drop it to Shaw. Andrew Shaw's rink wide was nearly picked off. Berry's without a stick, had to kick that one forward, and the Hawks bring it back in offside. Mentioned this briefly, Eddie, but the Avs have been a pretty good road team so far this year. They're 11-5-2 away from Denver so far this year, and they're point total of 24 on the road. And that's, there's only five teams in the league better than that, so. And they've been a team in the last couple of years that has given the Blackhawks trouble. I mean, they spanked them in Denver a few weeks back, and you remember they're the team that finally ended the record-setting 24-game unbeaten streak at the start of last season. And they won that game out in Colorado. So it's a team that, as we mentioned, has a tremendous amount of speed, and the last couple of years they've given the Hawks some fits. Here's a pass. Here's the front over the stick of Hossa, who was driving up the middle.
Good help there from Stastny on the back check on Marian Hossa.
Oh, a board battle in the Colorado zone. Hossa's got it. Hayda came to knock it loose. And Johnson goes off the glass. It is dribbled back to center. Here's Duncan Keith with 8 points in his last 7 games. Made a good pass to Sharp. He drives. He shoots. He scores. Patrick Sharp, the recipient of a nice feed from Duncan Keith, and off he went. It's 1-0. And Sharp remaining red hot. That's 8 goals in his last 9 starts.
Lots to look at. There's Patrick Sharp. Duncan Keith's going to be making this pass. But look at it in this area, Pat. The Blackhawks are going for a change. It's Sharp all by himself. He gets that puck standing still, hits another gear. It goes far side on J.S. Jaguar. What a release there from Patrick Sharp. Great pass from Keith. And that's a terrific look from behind J.S. Jaguar.
Right now, Oduya for Jalmerson. He's able to flip it ahead, and out come the Hawks. Smith chipped it deep. Now the Avs start back. Duchesne weaving into Chicago territory. Good stick, Jalmerson. Now the Avs get it back. Here's a long shot. Benoit that went wide. And Smith needs help along the boards. And O'Reilly momentarily held it in. And Oduya cleared it the other way.
Oh, big collision there in the middle of the ice. And it was Max Talbot and Brandon Bolig right in the middle of the ice, Pat. Almost like two ships passing in the night and colliding right, almost right at the faceoff dot at the red line.
Zeus's rink wide picked off. McGinn was checked. Good back check there by Versteeg. Down he goes. Penalty coming up to the end. So Talbot, who Eddie just mentioned a moment ago, will have a seat.
Well, it wasn't the initial stick across the legs of Chris Versteeg. Pat, you picked up on it. Chris Versteeg did a great job of coming all the way back to deny the first opportunity for the Avalanche. That extra effort, and then he draws the penalty. Well, a good shift there for Chris Versteeg.
Hawks power play, 15 goals in his last 12 games. Here's Keith. Sharp. Put it ahead to Kane. Shaw front of the net. Sharp, or I should say a Kane shot, was stopped by Jaguar. And Mitchell able to clear it.
Like that thought process there from Patrick Kane. Shoot the puck early. Maybe it softens up the defense a little bit. Then you can start making those quick little passes.
Keith. Let it taken away. Stasny. Looking ahead for McGinn. Out came Ranta to knock it away. And 80 seconds of power play time for Chicago. Kane wants it. He's got it. He bounced it up over the stick of Sharp, who then got it back. In behind, Shaw had a stick tied up.
Oh, interference there from Jaguar on Taves as he was going for that puck.
And Hawks changing him up here with a minute of power play time left. Letty to Saad stepping in. Bounced it towards Hossa. Then up the boards, Letty finds Versteeg. Back to Seabrook, and it jumped over his blade. Marian Hossa, 18 points in 16 games entering tonight. It's knocked loose. Duchesne sends it the other way. Back comes Seabrook. Letty. An extra move over the line forced an offside whistle. So this initial Blackhawks power play not getting a lot done. And their first chance tonight.
Yeah, for the second unit, they've had a tough time just getting the puck into the zone, setting it up. when that happens, Pat, the puck's got to be shot in, and you got to go get it. And everybody would like to carry the puck in and get it set up. Sometimes it's got to be old-fashioned meat and potatoes. Just shoot it in, go get it.
Eric Johnson, taken away by Kane, dropped it back to Hjalmarsson. Denver penalty over, both teams full strength. And Hanzus is back of the net. Tried to center for, and a shot, and a save by Jaguar on Hjalmarsson, who now has it again. Hanzus, Hjalmarsson takes a shot. That hit a skate out in front of Bickle. And Haida to the boards. Able to send it out of there.
Pierce had a tough time holding onto his stick pad in that crease. He just dropped it a couple of times.
Mitchell. Spun around by Bickle. But is able to put it across. Wilson sends it down low. Then got it back. Wilson shot. Never got to that. Good block, Hanzus. And Kane goes off the glass to make sure and get it out. Let's change him up quickly with 3.5 left in the first. And Ryan Wilson moved it ahead. Here comes Nathan MacKinnon, kicks to the stick. He's got wheels into the zone. Now pulls up. And a good stick from the Hawks. Bowling, able to tip the puck loose. Barry had to turn quickly, or Smith almost got there. Now the Avs. Barry gets the line. Taken away Keith, and back comes the Blackhawks. Ben Smith looking at a 6-game pointless drought. And his pocket picked along the boards. And now Keith able to gum up about 3 pass attempts from Matt Duchene. Must be thinking to himself, well, you get out of the way once. Oh, do you? Unable to get that out. Here's Stasny. Oh, and a good stick by Hossa. Tipped the centering pass away. Taves back to the other end. Jonathan Tate. A check by Haida. Patrick Sharp moves towards the middle, now lets it go. Owen put it up over top of the net. Well, they work in deep. Doug loose. Hossa, now it's up by Tate. It's gone. Hossa muscled to the front of the net and was knocked right to Taves, who pounded it home. It's 2-0.
Great support. Great support by the Hawks in the offensive zone. Forecheck by Hossa, support by Taves. Here comes Patrick Sharp, and as you mentioned, Pat, Jonathan Taves follows up after Marian Hossa takes his puck hard to the net, right here. And as Jaguar is down, Taves knows he has to elevate that puck upstairs. And the Hawks with a 2-0 lead. But strength in numbers in the offensive zone. Pat, that play all started because Paul Stastny turned the puck over as he entered the zone at the blue line. The Hawks turned the puck over. It was Johnny Oduya, and Stastny, instead of shooting the puck, he tried to get too cute, and the Hawks forced a turnover.
Here's Saad, whose shot was deflected up high. And the Avs, Mitchell, put it back into Chicago ice. Talbot tried to set a good stick, Shaw. Roosevelt looks towards Letty, who's got some skating room. Now a long pass was picked up by Saad. That's going to be a penalty. Too many men. Just as the Avalanche player jumped over the boards, the puck came to his neighborhood, and the Avs will get tagged for too many. Hawks to the power play with a 2-goal lead.
From our Xfinity Telestrator, there's Paul Stastny. I talked about the play here, Pat, where he has a chance to fire this puck, but he tries to get a little too cute. Look at all those sticks. No chance to make a play. And then about 17 seconds later, Hossa takes his puck to the net. Taves beats P.A. Parenteau, and the Hawks with a 2-0 lead. And you mentioned, Pat, too many men on the ice. And now what an opportunity here late in the first. The Hawks on a power play.
Yeah, get the draw, and Brennan tipped it loose. It came right to the middle. Talbot there, though, got rid of it. Now we get to the final minute of the opening period. Taves helped by Kane. Now Taves spins to the board, center to Kane. He tried to make one more pass. Jump to Taves. And they'll get things reorganized. Shaw to the front of the net. Here's Sharp with a blast. He's gone! Patrick Sharp has two in the first period on his 32nd birthday. And the Hawks are up three. And that's the 20-goal plateau for the sharpshooter. Quick puck movement there from Duncan Keith. The screen from Jan Heda. Goes right past J.S. Jagr, the same spot that he scored on and scored from Pat back in the first period. Low stick side on J.S. Jagr. That was a laser from Patrick Sharp. And the Hawks on the power play now up by three in the first. All right, now here's Kruger winning a battle, tried to center, just missing Smith. It comes to Jalmerson. And now Ben Smith from the corner got a pick from Bolig, but couldn't get it all the way out in front. Center to Bolig, point blank save made by Jagr. Great setup by Smith, and Bolig got rid of it quickly. Jagr able to make the stop. McKinnon, good stick there by Oduya at the blue line. And Johnny Oduya will clear it, and that's going to finish the opening period. The Blackhawks get three goals in the second half of the opening frame, two of them by that man, Patrick Sharp, another from Jonathan Taves, who now has 14 this year. Sharp scores numbers 19 and 20. And the Blackhawks outshoot Colorado 12-5 in the first, and they lead by a field goal.
Welcome back to the United Center. Blackhawks lead it 3-0 after one period at the Madhouse on Madison. Patrick Sharp now has a goal in 9 of his last 14 games. He has 2 on his birthday. How's that feel?
Feels pretty good, especially the young guys in the locker room calling me old. I had to go out there and prove to them I still had it, so it was a pretty good period.
All right, let's take a look at the first goal. Get a great assist from Duncan Keith, right?
Yeah, end of his shift, still had some jump in the legs, so I know Dunks is always looking for that breakaway pass, and felt like I could beat him to the net there, the defenseman, and you're not going to get much on your shot at the last second, but if I could just flick it into a corner, maybe beat the goalie who's already on his knees.
All right, let's take a look at the second one then.
We scored a few times like this during the season, just going wide on the blue line, and Andrew Shaw does such a good job in front of the net. I just had to kind of make my shot there. It wasn't the hardest one, but it was right in the corner.
You know, you talk about Duncan Keith. He leads the team in assists. He gets you that one on that. He's had a great season, hasn't he?
Yeah, he's had a great career. I mean, he's a guy that... so valuable to our team, arguably the best defenseman in the league. I think he is. And, you know, it seems like when things aren't going well, he takes a lot of heat. When things are going well, he's underrated. So it's nice to see he's got some recognition now that he's putting up some big numbers.
3-0 after one period. Did you feel any difference with the layoff at all from either team out there?
I think Joel does a great job of giving us a lot of time off and rest during the season. So, you know, 3 days off might be a lot for some teams. For us, I think we're kind of used to it, and we got smart guys in here that used it to our advantage. So they're kind of at a disadvantage traveling today and playing. We knew that. We wanted to come out and use our speed and quickness, and resulted in a few goals.
All right, go enjoy the rest of your birthday. Go get another one.
All right, man. Thank you. I will.
Patrick Sharp enjoying his birthday, and so are the Blackhawks so far. More intermission live after a quick timeout.
Blackhawks here on the back end of the Christmas break. 3-0 Blackhawks after 20 minutes. Back with Vinny's Beverage Depot intermission live. I got to cue them every once in a while.
They never know when they're going to be
they
out.
They never know.
They can't be up all the time.
Welcome in to Vinny's. I told you guys we were coming to you. Welcome to Vinny's Beverage Depot intermission live. Steve Conroy, Pat Boyle with you. Well, before the Christmas break, the three-star selection against the Devils was Hossa, Sharp, and Taves. that same top line was once again the best line in this first period.
Well, they had a dominating first shift, and actually the first four shifts by the Blackhawks in Colorado zone. Let's add Duncan Keith and Brent Seabrook to that threesome up front, because in that first period anyway, they were on the ice an awful lot with the Taves line.
The Blackhawks defensemen, as they've been much of the season, very engaged in the offensive zone in that first 20 minutes. Mm. Let's take a look at our Timberland Pro Hard Hits highlights. And it started early with that top line getting involved here. It was Duncan Keith walking in, and watch how he makes J.S. Giguere commit and then sends it across over to Jonathan Toews.
Yeah, at Blackhawks D, very active in that period. A lot of rotation. He gets them to commit Giguere. Perfect pass. Unfortunately, Jonathan Toews maybe blocked a little bit by Landeskog, but watch this pass by Duncan Keith. He had a great first period. Great speed here by Patrick Sharp. That's Jan Hayda, who came into the game plus 17. He was a minus 2 in that period. He gets a half a stride, and he puts it in that far post.
The 19th goal of the season for the birthday boy tonight, who turned 32. And then under two to go, after some hard work from Marian Hossa driving to the net, Jonathan Toews cleans up and scores his 14th.
Watch the power move by 81. He kind of passes it to himself along the boards right there, and then he cuts inside. That's a dangerous move. Jonathan Toews cleans up the loose change. That makes it 2-0, and a good shot there by the captain.
Then after too many men on the ice call, it was Sharp getting his second of the period. Another blistering pass from Duncan Keith there, his 32nd helper on the season.
That's why his nickname's Shooter, Patrick Sharp. He doesn't even look down at this puck, just settles it. Needs a little work on the celly, and then a blast. Maybe Giguere screened a bit by Hayda, but he finds that post again. That makes it 3-0.
All Blackhawks in the first 30 minutes. What is it about Sharp, on momentous occasions in his career and his life? The birth of both of his daughters, he comes back in the next game, has big nights. And I guess tonight certainly doesn't match the birth of one of your daughters, but on his birthday, he gets things going. Maybe a little drive to make that Team Canada selection for the Olympics
Could be. That's four goals in the last four periods for number 10. And we're going to figure out some kind of a festival for him every time he plays.
We mentioned earlier in the pregame show, Colorado flew into here. NHL rules say you can't travel during those 2 days during the Christmas break. Expecting a little bit more from Colorado here.
Yeah, they're getting it from their coach right now, and they'll be a lot better. Just a quick shout out to a happy birthday, Anthony Tavolino's 30 years old today. Grew up just down the street on Taylor Street, and Scott, who rings the bell for the Salvation Army outside of the Macy's in Oak Brook, he's a huge Blackhawks fan.
Hopefully, they're having as good a birthday as Patrick Sharp is. 3-0 Blackhawks. That'll do it for Binney's Beverage Depot. Intermission live. The second period is coming your way next. You're watching the defending Stanley Cup champs on CSN.
The Hawks with a 3-0 lead against the Colorado Avalanche to get ready to start the second period. Well, a lot was talked about last year, partner, about realignment. And now with the Central Division adding a few teams and Winnipeg coming back to the Western Conference, and you take a look, Central Division foes, the Hawks and the Avalanche. And the Hawks' next opponent tomorrow night, the St. Louis Blues. So after tonight, Pat, the Blues will have four games in hand. And if the Hawks, the score stays the same here, the Hawks will have a 7-point lead. And a lot of hockey to be played.
Yeah, the Hawks tomorrow, they just get to the halfway point of the season. So that looms as a rather important get-together tomorrow night in Missouri.
Yeah, the Hawks 0-2 against the Blues so far this season. Two close games, two one-goal games, and the second period of Blackhawk hockey is brought to you by Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Honda dealers.
Pass sailed away from Duchesne, so the icing whistle goes.
Well, besides everybody here in Chicago, we'd like to welcome those viewing tonight's game on the Comcast Network. Thanks a lot for joining us, and happy holidays.
That puck comes right to J.S. Giguere, who is trying. He's not in position to do it right now, but Coming into the game, he was tied with Ken Dryden with 258 career victories. That's tied for 44th in NHL history. But he's going to need his offense to light it up if he wants to break that deadlock. Chalmerson, a long shot that dipped on its way to the net. Rebound, Sharp, he scores! The third career hat trick for Patrick Sharp. Happy birthday to the sharpshooter, and it's 4-0. Well, 27 seconds in to the second period, the shot from Nicholas Chalmerson. Patrick Sharp with the hot stick goes to the front of the net, finds a rolling puck, and is able to beat J.S. Jagr for the hat trick.
Well, Eddie, you talked right at the start of our broadcast tonight about Brandon Saad and the great year that he's had in so many different areas, and you're feeling that he should be a member of Team USA when the Olympics roll around. Sharp has been one of those guys talked about as a potential forward for Team Canada. Yeah. Well, they always, the guys putting that team together have always talked about keeping a very close eye on how people are playing, and yeah. Now as the Olympics are getting a little closer, how about 10 goals in the last 9 games and 21 for the year? Well, for Steve, he wants to make the decision for Steve Yzerman and that whole group as hard as he can.
Yeah, the way he is playing right now, Pat. And look, he got off to a slow start. There's no doubt about it. But you could argue not many players hotter in the National Hockey League over the course of the last 25 games than Patrick Sharp. And there's no doubt that he deserves to be there with his production for the Blackhawks during the regular season.
Now they battle in the Colorado end.
Not easy to score goals. I don't care what league you're in.
But he has been on a spectacular roll. And Benoit's going to have to play this, pressured by Kruger. He's able to get help from Stasny. Andre Benoit cleared it to center. Landeskog tried to work a give and go, but Letty in the way of the second pass. And now Roosevelt will put it on the stick of Kane. And now to Versteeg. Chris Versteeg scooped it to Nick Letty. Looking back towards Versteeg. Bats it out of the air. What a save by Jagr. A neat play by Versteeg as he batted a waist-high puck right to the net. Now it's loose back for Versteeg. He got checked, carried on Hanzus, whose pass was read and picked off McGinn. He's unable to complete a feed. Kane right back in there. Patrick Kane looking for his first point to a spinorama, drives and shoots, and the stuff shot denied by Jagr.
And Jagr tried to take a little slash at Patrick Kane as he went to the net. And Ryan Wilson, the defenseman, is one of the more harder hitters in the National Hockey League. And I don't know if he's not seen video before. When Patrick Kane comes down on that off wing, left-handed shot coming down and spinning around like that. There's that great hand-eye coordination from Chris Versteeg. And a good stop there from J.S. Jagr. Again, that lack of predictability from Patrick Kane is allowing him to be able to make plays just like that. And
He probably tries that move, Pat. What would you say? Once every, what, three, four games maybe? Five games?
Is that fair? A couple weeks. Yeah. I think you're right. Yeah, right in the ballpark.
Yeah. On Ryan Wilson there again. He's trying to cane that. He's trying to get Wilson to lean into the middle of the ice. And, you know, sometimes Kane will just fire that puck as well. So you got to keep, you know, keeps defenseman honest. And he's coming down with so much speed. And I think he was actually surprised at how easily he got in behind Wilson, Pat. But again, I go back to the start of the game and talk about it. I can't believe that the Avalanche did not skate here this morning. I know the game's 4-0. It's easy to say. But we talked about it right at the start. I mean, to go almost four days without getting on the ice and getting some sort of sweat and some timing in is really unheard of. And then go play a game like this against the Hawks.
Shaw, guy to center, is a little too far for Saad. Well, Brandon Saad up to Nick Chalmers, who's got two assists. His long shot here is blocked. Now a shot and a save by Jaguar. Then it might have gotten through and hit the post as well as the initial attempt to take it by Bickle. Yeah, it's just a need, an icing call. Well, Eddie, I mean, to that point, and we talked about it before the game, but our good friend, the great color analyst for the Colorado Avalanche, Peter McNabb, we were talking with him about this before the game tonight. Athletes are, you know, they fall into patterns. They've got their habits. They got their routines. But, I mean, in this case, with three complete days off, I mean, the Avalanche, most of their guys would have had 12 meals between workouts. I mean, now, you and I were talking off the air after the first period, and, you know, their legs still seem to be in baggage claim.
Yeah.
You know, especially in the first 20 minutes tonight. And I think the difficult set of circumstances. Now, here they are. It's a two-hour flight. If you try to time everything out, they would have had to leave at 6:30 or 7 in the morning, losing an hour with a two-hour flight to get to Chicago in time to get a morning skate. But, I mean, to me, I don't know how you don't do that.
Yeah, I think you have to. There is no doubt about that again. I mean, you really never. I mean, never in a schedule do you ever go 3 days during the course of a regular season and not be on the ice.
Taves for Sharp. Why not try again? That one was shot wide, though. Keith, who's got two assists already, looking for Hossa. That jumped away. Well, picked up by Sharp. An extra move, though, forced Taves in ahead of the play.
Well, tomorrow the Bulls are back here at the United Center to take on the Dallas Mavericks. Coverage begins at 6:30 with McDonald's Bulls pregame live with Ski Mark Skanowski. Bulls Mavericks tomorrow night right here. Comcast Sportsnet. Boy, Duncan Keith, you made mention two assists tonight. Not sure what's going on and with Crosby and Nicholas Backstrom, but now Duncan Keith's got 32. Now he's tied for fourth with Evgeny Malkin of the Pittsburgh Penguins. Been there. He's been in the top five all, really, for the last, 25 games. He's been top five of any player in the National Hockey League.
Here's a quick shot. Oh, the puck found the blade of Bolig. He let it go in a hurry, but Jaguar made the save.
Oh, Brandon Bolig's had two quality chances here. Good forecheck from Ben Smith, and then Bolig following up. And there you see Bolig checking out the Jumbotron there, Pat, shaking his head. Just going to say, I'm glad there was no Jumbotron when I played, because I would have done a lot of shaking. A whole lot of shaking going on.
Now, the start of your career, talk about the video aspect. And, of course, you know, Roger Nielsen was maybe the initial guy to really use video regularly. I mean, when did it start becoming a factor in the NHL for you?
Yeah, Pat, I used to, I guess I'm dating myself, but in the VCR days, I used to put a tape in, set it for the game, and I'd watch it. I would kind of pretty much do my own at home. But I think it became really, really evident in the mid-80s. Oh, and don't forget, Roger Nielsen was here, part of the Blackhawks staff in the early 80s. I would say that most teams probably caught on to it in you know, late 80s, early 90s for sure, where everybody had that opportunity.
Good chance here for Stasio. That shot was partially blocked. Landeskog goes back. Johnson shot it up high off the glass.
He didn't have a lot of meetings, though, Pat, back in the day. I mean, you know, not a lot. He just, you know, that's what you have scouts for, to watch games.
Here's a steal by Kane, looking to get in. Kane stick handling, shooting. Jagr got a piece, and it's out of play. Well, Patrick Kane with a 12-game point streak alive so far has been held off the score sheet tonight, but not without a couple of dandy opportunities.
They had one on a power play back in the first period. That last opportunity, good idea. Avalanche coming all the way back. But really, that's how it's changed, Pat, just to go back with the video. I mean, now, and you know, the last, what, 15, 20, 25 years, whatever you want to say, now, I mean, you're able to go ahead and see how a team breaks out and how they forecheck. We're back a long time ago. It was, okay, this is what our scouts were seeing, and this is how they do it. And got to get the chalkboard and a dry erase board out. And that's how you would pretty much know what a team's tendencies were. Things have changed big time.
Well, here's another change. As a lead pass finds Shaw in on Wilson. Shaw waits for help, tried to slip it in front, but that didn't work out. A steal by Bickle. Shooting. Missed the net.
Oh, what a release there from Bickle. Same area of the ice that he scored the other night against New Jersey on Corey Schneider.
Eddie, though, I just realized that when you're talking about setting the VHS to look at your games again, I guess that was only for road games, right?
Yeah, and then until I got shipped out of Chicago and went to Toronto and Winnipeg, would, you know, set the VCR and had a remote control, too, by the way, with the...
Wow. Pretty high tech.
Well, that was the one way that I would, you know, just kind of get an opportunity to watch and scout out, and I don't know if we have a little notepad to go with it.
Here's a shot. Ronta made the save, then kicked out the right pad. That puck was dribbling towards the line when he, after he got the initial piece, and is able to keep his pad along the ice and kick it free and prevent it from entering the net. That was just the sixth shot on goal for Denver tonight.
To the net, and Patrick Sharp started the night with 18 goals. Back in the first, great pass from Duncan Keith. There's Sharpie's 19th. But he wasn't done on the power play. Keith again to Sharp. That's number 20. And here, 27 seconds into the third period, Patrick Sharp's 21st. Now he's moved into the top 10 in scoring, Pat, in the entire National Hockey League. And what a night. What a first half of the game for number 10.
Bortolo battling with Roosevelt. And the Avs will have to chase back. Andre Benoit.
Sounds like a wrestler, Andre Benoit. Yeah.
He does. Wonder if he would eat the turnbuckle. Who was that? The Animal. George the Animal.
George the Animal Steel. Love that guy.
I don't think puck missed Bortolo. It comes to Cleish. He was a teacher, wasn't he, in the Animal? I think he was. Oh, here's a near turnover, but it's going to be held in. Hayda goes across to Johnson. And Eric Johnson cleared it up the boards.
What was he, a nutritionist or something?
Somehow I think calculus might have been in there. All right, here's Kane, Kyle O'Reilly, and the Avs get it back. Here's a lead pass to Duchesne. He's going to get in. Duchesne, a breakaway. Oh, what a play! Patrick Sharp lifted his stick and stripped him. Back comes Hayes to the other end. Right in from Sharp, tap in. Defense leading to offense, and the captain scores his second of the game. Those two have five between them.
Pat, the Hawks got lucky. They were in the middle of a change. It wasn't a good change. Matt Duchesne is in all alone. All you young hockey players out there, the guy that makes the play has three goals in the game. And I'll guarantee you,
This will be the one that the coaches and their teammates talk about the most. The back check and then a beautiful move and patience from Jonathan Toews. Hossa goes hard to the net. Eric Johnson, I'm not sure where he went on that play. No chance for J.S. Jaguar. And it's all Hawks, but what a play.
Our fans, Eddie, may have noticed as we had that look into the Colorado zone, the Hawks are so hot, the red light is still on behind Jaguar. Blinking away. Here's a long one. Wilson blocked it away by Ranta. Now Landeskog works his way in deep. Trying to center. Oh, Ranta! Rebound, they score! Stasny got his own rebound and managed to poke it to the back of the net. So the Avs on the board, trailing now 5-1.
Well, that was the play right there. Landeskog got inside position on Brent Seabrook and a second chance opportunity for Paul Stastny. First save, and then on the backhand, elevation. But Landeskog used his size and speed to get in on a forecheck, found the puck below the goal line. And Stastny beat Toews to the front, and it's now 5-1.
All right, now the Avs, from their own end, have Mitchell. Feathered it ahead, picked out of the air by Hjalmarsson. And Benoit goes across. Guinan to the stick of Talbot, but he had a jump free. Hjalmarsson. Only get the official out of his way. And now a penalty coming up. Hjalmarsson, he grabbed the stick of the Av forward, and Hawks are going to be shorthanded for the first time.
Right there you see Nicholas Hjalmarsson. Looked like he almost kind of had the hand wrapped around the stick there of Max Talbot, who was going to grab that puck. So now all of a sudden, Pat, the Avalanche get a goal. Now they're going on a power play. And now that goal light is on again in behind J.S. Jaguar.
And the Avs, before Christmas, they do finally get that goal light turned off, but before Christmas, the Avs had a nice power play run going. They had scored four straight games. Five of the last 15 they have converted. And their first opportunity here.
Good faceoff went there, and good setup from Seabrook and Keith to clear the zone. Kill off a good 25 seconds when you win a faceoff to start that penalty killing situation.
Stasny got help from Benoit. Back to Paul Stasny, whose rink wide is off the skate of Hanzus and out. Oh, a great chance for the Hawks to change the forwards. A 30-second shift for the first two. Now it's Hossa with Toews. Seabrook, he gets a second chance and fires at the length of the ice. And Jaguar wanted to come out and play that. Seeing some pressure coming from a hard-working Toews. Finally, the Avs retrieve. Now Toews and Hossa change him up. And Hanzus and Kruger right back out. MacKinnon dropped it back. Here's Johnson with a one-timer tip, and the redirect went up high. That one stung Kruger, who made the block. O'Reilly checked by Oduya. And MacKinnon dropped it back. Here's Duchesne sending it down low. The goalmouth pass didn't connect with a couple of Avs players. And Roosevelt sends it the other way. Good half a minute of power play time.
Sorry, Pat. Good anticipation there from Roosevelt with the pressure coming from Kruger on Johnson.
Duchesne rolled it into O'Reilly. His drop pass was read by Smith. Brandon Saad out with Smith at the end of the PK. Now Duchesne bounced it to the other side. McKinnon could not pick it up, and that will finish the Chicago penalty. Both teams at full strength. Roosevelt looks towards Sharp. Checked by Benoit. Now Letty. Let his pass jump to Johnson. And back goes Nick Letty. The pass was read but not stolen cleanly by Guenin. And now it's Roosevelt. Kane with a neat reception there. Got it to Shaw into the zone. Andrew Shaw for Patrick Kane. He shoots. Got the outside of the goalpost, and it's a flex. Out of play. We have played 33 minutes in the game. The Avalanche have 9 shots, 20 for the Hawks.
Well, time now for our ANA Airlines upcoming schedule. Tomorrow night in St. Louis. Close out 2013 against the LA Kings on Monday night, and then head off to the Islanders for 2014. Pat, you made mention during the penalty kill, and it was a great pickup by you, partner. The Hawks made 2 changes with their forwards in the first minute.
Yeah.
You had Kruger and Hanzus for about 20. You had Taves and Hossa for about 25. And then those other guys came out right at the 1 minute mark remaining. That's the way that you have a strong penalty kill. You got to win a faceoff to start, and you got to know when to change. Usually the rule is
here's Kane right to the goal, put it in front, and a tap in for Michael Hanzus. It's set up by Patrick Kane, who extends his scoring streak to 13 in a row. And there's been only once in the last 26 games where Patrick Kane hasn't been on the score sheet.
What a play from Christopher Stieg in the corner, Pat, to the left of J.S. Jaguar. Good pressure from Hanzus. There's Verstegen, and look at his backhand pass. Wow, what a play, and an even better play from Patrick Kane to throw it back against the grain. And Hanzus has a wide open net. Just to finish the thought on the penalty kill, Pat, really the mindset is up and down and off. Get it down, get fresh bodies on the ice. You don't ever get caught extended while being shorthanded, and the Blackhawks did a great job on that last penalty kill. And Pat, Patrick, arguably one of the greatest goaltenders of my lifetime. I got to imagine at some point J.S. Jaguar is gonna just get out of the net and give him the rest of the night off. He's not getting a lot of help at all. And
well, the question is, with the Avs being as out of sync as they are, do you put your starter Varlamov in there in a game you're not going to win? I mean, to me, I think this is the relief pitcher taking a hit for the team. Yeah. I'm really curious as this game goes along if the Hawks keep lighting the lamp. Remember Patrick Roy?
Sure.
Well, the last game he ever played Montreal, yeah. He felt he was embarrassed, right? He said, "I'm never playing for this team again."
It's a wake-up call for the guys on the ice. But to me, I would have had him out of there after that last one. But we'll see what happens maybe after the second period. But an important penalty kill, Pat. Even though the game was 5-1, the Hawks did a real good job. And then the beautiful play from Versteeg. What a pass, though, by Versteeg on the backhand. Yeah. To get it to Kane, and then that beautiful pass. Move left, pass right. And Michael Hanzus has a wide open cage.
Duchesne. His pass broken up. Good stick, Oduya. Jan Hayda goes down low to Matt Duchesne. He's checked by Oduya. Johnson pressured by Bolick. And now Jalmerson. Scoop to the head. And now the Avs able to gain control. Hayda put it ahead. McKinnon chipped it. And Letty gets support from Shaw. Andrew Shaw, good pass to Bickle. He was checked before he could pull the trigger. Shaw tries, but shot it wide. Close the ball to Saad. Now Shaw.
One of these games, Pat, we know Joel Quenneville's a four-line coach, but you get in this situation, you can really, really extend your bench here.
Well, and especially with a big game tomorrow night. Everybody's going to be playing a lot here as we move on as Ranta grabs an easy wrister. With 3.5 remaining in the second period, of the Hawks in a runaway. Michael Hanzus finishing off a sweet pass from Kane as well as for Steve. Applications are now being accepted for the 2014 Eddie Olczyk Award. Now, the Olczyk Award will provide financial assistance to Illinois youth hockey players, teams, or organizations who otherwise may not have the chance to play. Letters of inquiry are due by Friday, January the 10th. So you can apply by checking out chicagoblackhawks.com/youth hockey. It's a great program and a wonderful opportunity for kids to get some help to participate in this wonderful game. But the clock's starting to run on that, so think about checking out blackhawks.com/youth hockey. As Roosevelt nearly turned it over. Now Shaw comes away. And now it's clear to the Chicago end by Cleach. Bickle picked it up, tipped it forward. Shaw able to lift the stick and kick it out of the zone.
A good play from Shaw.
And now he's going to steal from Wilson. Shaw looking to drive the net. He got rid of a one-hand shot, but it hit the side of the goal. Seabrook kept it in. Now Bickle missed side of the pass. So back goes Keith. Seabrook will fire it around the boards. Benoit to this side for Parenteau. And Stasny got into the zone. Did not beat the second man, Versteeg, with another good back check there. And now he's going to lead the Hawks up the ice. Versteeg left it for Keith. Duncan Keith for Versteeg was tipped to him. He scored! What a lucky bounce. When you're hot, you're hot for the Blackhawks. That pass was way out of the reach of Chris Versteeg. It hit a Colorado stick, came right into his wheelhouse. Bang! 7-1.
Well, Michael Hanzus with the quick outlet. The Duncan Keith little give and go. Duncan Keith trying to put this puck all the way across. Goes right off the stick of Benoit and right to the stick of Chris Versteeg, who goes short side on J.S. Jagr. A little payback there, partner. Remember, Versteeg's the guy that knocked the puck out of midair earlier in the period, and Jagr made the great save. Well, great things happen when you get to the net, and again, good offense or good defense leads to good offensive opportunity from Hanzus to Keith. Little give and go, and the Hawks got 7 on the board.
A steal by Sharp for Taves, a shot that's blocked, and now the Avs start back. Here's O'Reilly, a drag move, he shoots, good save through a screen by Ranta. Now here's another long one going wide. Hayda kept it in. And a turnover to O'Reilly, but it escaped him. Here's a chance for the Hawks bowling. Oh, that one hit him right in the headgear, and Jagr shaken up. He's asking for the official to stop the play. It took an extra moment for Francis Charron to do that. And boy, as if the night hasn't been hard enough for J.S. Jagr, getting no support. And Now he takes one right in the yap.
Yeah, he waved off the medical trainer for the Avalanche. I mean, right away, and this was a heavy, hard shot from Brandon Bolig. I mean, square right in the chin, and you see the snap on that mask come right off. Watch the snap and the strap right there, and you see the helmet or the mask come loose, and PSG right away gets the attention of the official.
Able to get this one in. Barry lifted up the boards into the final minute of period two. Talbot linked together with Roosevelt. Then Bolig acted up the boards and Mitchell kept it in. Letty took a hit, but able to get it to Bolig. His pass off a skate. Lines up out of the zone. Then the Avs are back in offside.
Will our celebrity shoot the puck? He's got a big game on Sunday. That's Michael Busch. Bears. Bears running back. Native of Louisville, Kentucky. My kind of guy. I wonder if he's ever been to the Derby.
Well, I wonder how many athletes live in Louisville and would answer that no. I don't think that's a very long list. Oh, well, Landeskog shot, hit some traffic out in front. Puck jumped around a couple of times, finally picked up Benoit, sends it in behind, three left, and trying to get it out in front. Here's a shot, Ranta in the final second. Antti Ranta denies a point blank Avs opportunity.
Boy, from our captain, Morgan's RoboCam, what a stop. Gabriel Landeskog, the left glove of Antti Ranta, says absolutely not as time coming off the clock in the second period. What a save.
Hawks out shoot the Avs 12-7 in the second. It's 24-12 so far in the game. And the Blackhawks had a 3-0 lead coming in. Patrick Sharp scored his hat trick goal. Then he sent Jonathan Toews in point blank. Stastny got one back for Denver. Then Hanzus finished off a great passing play, and Versteeg added his eighth.
This period.
Avalanche with one. 7-1 after 40 minutes. Welcome into Binney's Beverage Depot intermission live. Patrick Sharp has his third career hat trick on his 32nd birthday. Mike Simon, Steve Conrad, I am Pat Boyle. It's the 17th time this season, 17 games, that the Blackhawks have scored at least 5 goals in a contest. Amazing offensive display, but they're not stopping on the defensive end. Sharp back checking. Mm-hmm. Solid penalty kill when it's 5-1. And oh, by the way, Ranta makes a key stop every once in a while,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, it's those little things, especially the defense. And the Blackhawks realize, hey, good defense wins you a game. Ranta, yeah, not tested a lot, made some big saves. I'll tell you what, 3 of those 7 goals they've scored, Colorado had the puck. Chicago just flat out stole it from them and then scored their goals.
Take a look at the moving pictures. A lot to get to from that second period. Our Timberland Prohard hits highlights. And opening seconds of that frame. Jesse Garrett gives up a rebound, and Patrick Sharp is there for his 21st goal, the birthday boy with his third career hat trick.
You know, Hayda and Johnson are the two shutdown guys for the Colorado Avalanche. They're currently -4 after 2 periods. Great job by Patrick Sharp. That's quick hands, and that's jumping on a loose puck.
You surprised Patrick Waugh didn't pull Shiguer at some point in that second?
I really am, Pat. I'm thinking maybe that Varlamov's sick or injured. There's got to be some reason he's not going in with the other guy.
How about this play by Sharp? Lifting Matt Duchene's stick. They counter the other way, and the captain Don't tase me, bro. Scores the second of the night.
Wow. I mean, that's just work at both ends of the ice. Look at the back checking here. Duchesne's maybe the fastest guy on this Colorado team. Sharpie tracks him down, and oh, yeah, makes a 150-foot pass to that man. Jonathan Toews freezes the goalie. Jaguar's really been down early, getting put out of position.
Toews with his 15. It's 5-1 at this point. Patrick Kane driving hard to the net. Nice pass by Hanzus and a great pass by Versteeg before that.
Yeah, Hanzus started it though on the forecheck. Versteeg jumped on the loose puck and there's that give and go, that pass from Kane to Hanzus. And boy, it's just been all Blackhawks.
Patrick Kane extends his point streak now to 13 games. There you see the shots on goal, 24-12. With the game tomorrow in St. Louis, do you expect Joel to try to extend that bench, roll those four lines, try to get some of those guys on that fourth line, a little more ice time, take some minutes off his top couple?
Yeah, I think he's been doing a pretty good job of getting all four lines involved, and yeah, you're certainly going to see that. I'll tell you what, in games like this, though, guys want to be on the ice all the time.
These guys are into it. We've got a couple birthday shout-outs for you. Travis and Tino had birthdays today, along with Patrick Sharp. No surprise, Hossa and Sharp are their high-flying Hawks. We'll find out who Steve's high-flying Hawk is on the post-game show. That'll do it for Vinny's Beverage Depot Intermission Live. The third period is coming up next.
Welcome back to the United Center, where the Blackhawks will take a 6-goal lead into the third period. Before that happens, we get to talk to assistant coach Mike Kitchen. And Kitchen, you've been filling the net. I want to ask you about a guy who's not yet on the score sheet. Eddie has been talking a lot about Brandon Saad the last little bit. Could you, from a coaching perspective, tell our audience about what has impressed you the most about him, his versatility, and just some of the things he brings to this group?
We play him in all situations, 5-on-5, power play, penalty killing, and he's done tremendously well at it. And now we have him on the right side playing with Bickle and Shaw, so he's done a great job there. He played on the right side when he was younger, played in junior hockey, but other than that, he hasn't played on the right side pro, so he's made these adjustments very easily. And that's the signs of a real good hockey player, you know. There's not much there. He knows what his game's all about. He's a power forward, takes the puck to the net, and he's got some good speed. When those legs are moving, he's hard to stop.
Hey, Kitch, Patrick Sharp, nobody hotter tonight or in the National Hockey League right now than Patrick Sharp with the hat trick. I don't want to talk about his goals. Tell me, what was the feeling on the bench when he stole the puck from Matt Duchesne on that breakaway?
Oh, what a great back check. We were just saying in the office, in the coach's office there, you know, it could have been a, you know, possibility. You're looking to maybe get a penalty shot against him when you're coming from behind like that. But that was a clean pick of the stick, turnaround, and made a great up-ice play to Johnny Toews, and it ends up in their net. So it was a terrific play by Sharpie. He's had a hell of a game.
He sure has. All right, Toews, your whole team. Good luck here in the third, Kitch.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks. Kitch.
Here's a long shot going just wide. Meanwhile, Varlamov is in the game for Colorado. Parenteau's pass deflected to Johnson. He put it across Haida, rings it around.
And this third period of Blackhawk hockey is brought to you by Chevy and ChevyDriveChicago.com.
Stasny goes down low. Landeskog trying to center one. Here's a shot by Johnson, missing the net. And by the way, I'm not sure we've mentioned this, but the Colorado defense, so one of their defensemen has scored in each of the last five games that the Avs have played. And their only goal so far tonight from Stasny, but the Colorado defense has scored 16 goals as a group. Blackhawks defensemen have scored 19 goals entering the action tonight.
Well, as we mentioned couple of times earlier, partner, besides everybody here in the Chicago market, we'd like to welcome those viewers tuning in to tonight's game on the Comcast Network. Hopefully you're enjoying your holiday season.
This puck cleared back to the Colorado line. Shot it the other way.
I'm not going to ask you if I sound raspy again tonight, partner, because once I said that to you the other night, you know what happened. I couldn't talk for 2 days. I think that might have been a good thing around the Olchek household.
Well, the full Olchek household, which we're glad to hear.
Yeah, the grocery bill went from $195 to $700.
A long shot for Stieg. That hits some traffic out in front. that cleared to center. So, yeah, the only bad thing about you having all those four kids home is I'm missing my Diane Olchek cookies. I'm sure they've
gone.
They've been all, oh, yeah, they're
they had,
long
they
gone.
Had no chance. Yeah. Those 10 dozen she made were all after you got a baker's dozen, everybody else inhaled them.
Well, there's a guy who carried the bulk of the load for the Avs so far this season. And J.S. Jaguar was hit for 7 goals and 24 shots. But quite often, more than a little fair to say, he was left to fend for himself.
No question. No question.
Mitchell could not keep that one in. And now Talbot and Letty get together in the corner. Next team Talbot jammed it loose, but retrieved by Hanzus. So Hanzus hit hard as he made a drop pass. He's a little slow to get up. And Wilson, you talked about him earlier. When he brings a load, he brings one, and he got a good piece of Hanzus there.
Pat, Michael Hanzus, when he made that drop pass against the boards, once he looked back, Wilson stepped right up, and he had no chance. And I know exactly what that feeling is like.
Now they get in Cleese with a shot, and a save. Ronta rebound loose, and Bortolo could not pull it to the backhand cleanly. So Jalmerson the other way, in for Shaw, then Saad. And then the Avs, Bortolo, rolled it out to center. Cleese dumped it.
Well, Michael Hanzus' helmet was on the ice, and found its way back to the Blackhawk bench. He would not be allowed to come back onto the ice without a helmet to start his next shift. He could certainly borrow somebody else's, but there's Michael Hanzus, and our BMO Harris Bank Telestrator, or our BMO Harris Bank check replay will show us. He makes a drop pass, looks back, and then a good hard hit there from Ryan Wilson. He looks back after he drops it. That's almost shoulder on side, Pat. I mean, I know the hands look high, the sticks look high, but the contact, that's a good hit.
And what was one of the first, if you didn't know it before he got to the NHL, I'm sure within the first week, especially back in the day when you started playing, don't admire your pass, that's son. It. Here's a stuff attempt denied by Varlamov, and he was able to cover.
Well, head out to the official Road Watch tomorrow at Mr. D Sports Bar, located at 2200 West Euclid in Arlington Heights. That's Arlington Park. Head out to Mr. D's. Fans will enjoy a Blackhawks home game experience, and the first 100 fans who arrive receive a giveaway item. Hawks and Blues tomorrow night from St. Louis.
Taves brings it around. Sharp for Hossa. Now Haida for the Avs, put it up the boards. Hossa able to keep it in. And Landeskog, the Colorado captain, sends it across. Here's Haida to Gabriel Landeskog. Dropped it back. P.A. Parenteau put it to the line. Benoit's long shot into the glove of Ranta.
Easy save there. Nobody in front of Antti Ranta. Oh, quick shout out to the student body from Oklahoma State University in town. Cooper Page, Ronnie Schmock, and two Chicago kids, Tommy Carlson and Anthony Lincoln, held in attendance at tonight's game. Enjoying a 6-goal cushion to this point over the Avalanche.
And we have a pane of glass that has been slightly dislodged, so Jimmy Kohler got his whistle out. He sounded the alarm, and here comes the great UC staff to get things figured out, which gives me a chance to give a shout out as well to some of the extended Foley family. some people very important to us, and a happy birthday wish to the lovely Fabi Guerrero. She and her husband, Pedro, have raised three great kids. Their son, Michael, is a Northwestern grad. Two of their boys, Jose and Christian, are in the Marines. We thank them for their service, but happy birthday today to a great Blackhawks fan and a great family, Fabi Guerrero. Well, they try to get everything back in place in the corner, and now look like they're ready to go.
Well, somebody's got their credit card out down there in the front row. Hey, I better check. Everybody else in the household's got it. I think the locks will be a little different. I get home and tomorrow night, the Hawks will jump on their charter tonight after the game and head to St. Louis.
Little does that gentleman know what a great favorite Dave Turner just did by not zooming in on that on that card. All right, they try to work a give and go, but we'll have to regroup. 5 minutes gone by here in the third. A 7-1 Chicago lead. Smith chipped it in. And the Avs, Walsh right out. Duchesne in for Berry. Threw it to the other side. Rosenthal first there. Then he turned it over. Here's a loose puck in front. And a centering pass from Talbot didn't quite connect with Duchesne. Anzus doesn't miss a shift. Put it ahead for Kane. Patrick Kane to the middle. Got rid of a check. Cuts in. Couldn't pull the trigger. Kane able to hang on, though, to Rosenthal. Looks back to Kane right in. Oh, and his shot partially blocked as he let it go. He gets it back. Kane again. Right to the middle on his backhand. Shooting. It'll save Varlamov. The Kane show on that shift.
This all started because of a great exit out of the zone by Chris Versteeg. Support, give and go, Rosenthal and Kane. Little bit of a pick there on Max Talbot to allow that spacing for Patrick Kane to get to the backhand. Probably a good thing that Versteeg lost his balance there, Pat. I don't think there's any doubt there's that, that subtle little moving pick there by Versteeg on Talbot to open up space for 88.
Who put it to Versteeg. His shot, though, is blocked. Now the Avs, Haida, put it up the boards. Held in, Letty tried to center one, and Anzus's feed stolen away. Back come the Avs, but a good stick by Rosenthal in his own end. Versteeg to the other zone, left it for Kane. Versteeg hit hard, but they play on. Here's a shot, and a save, Varlamov, and then the post got a piece of it as well. Haida will send it forward, and Mitchell chipped it deep. Is looking to complete a change as Chalmerson starts the Hawks back. Chased down by Shaw, his centering pass, and a good save by Varlamov on Saad, who was driving up the middle. A perfect pass from Shaw gave him an opportunity. Varlamov shut the door. Brought to you by Miller Lite.
Well, the hat trick for Patrick Sharp. 27 seconds into the second period.
And look at that. Patrick Sharp has become the first Blackhawk to ever register a hat trick on his birthday. And it hasn't happened in the NHL for more than a decade.
Yeah, Pavel Dimitra. And Joel Quenneville was behind the bench when that last happened for Pavel Dimitra in St. Louis. I got to give Coach Q a call in August sometime. See if he's available. On my 29th birthday coming up.
Oh, good. Well, and I'm liking your chances against some of the goalies you'll see in August. Right now they have Gennon checked. Saad put it across the goal mouth end. Back comes the Avs. Here's a lead pass for Landeskog. He scores. Nice pass from P.A. Parenteau. He sprung Gabriel Landeskog, and the youngest captain of the NHL scooped home a backhander. It's 7-2.
Well, Landeskog gets in behind Brent Seabrook. This puck, watch how this puck bounces over the stick of Duncan Keith right there. And Landeskog is able to settle it down at the last second when he goes forehand back. And look at that puck. I mean, it's on edge. Landeskog gets in behind Brent Seabrook, and a little forehand backhand top shelf by the captain. One move only.
Landeskog had only one goal in his previous 11 games, so Evs very happy to see him put one home and maybe get his game going again.
He's a guy that he's not afraid to shoot the puck either, Pat. We talk a lot about it. I mean, anytime he gets over the blue line in more situations than not, he's going to think about shooting first. Should have been a penalty.
Taves walks in, shooting. Valov off the save. It's up high to the air. It bounced over Hossa's stick as he took a whack. And they're able to clear it.
And Barry with a little deception there, a little traveling call. I'm sure Stacey King would have picked that one up.
Barry and Hossa rolled it towards the middle. It deflected. Now lines up in behind with Sharp, who's got 4 points in the game, 3 goals and a helper. Mitchell scooped it out to center. And now back goes Rosenthal. Mounzou's there to help out. And out comes Kane. Patrick Kane. Not get away from Eric Johnson. Now it came in front. Hounzou's a stuff shot. And downstairs was Varlamov, able to smother the opportunity.
Well, tonight after the game, stick around for Sportsnet Central presented by GMC. On the show, Bears kicker Robbie Gould, congratulations, a belated Christmas present. We'll tell you what it is. Plus, we'll have bowl highlights from today's game. Don't miss Sportsnet Central tonight after Hawks Post Game Live, only on Comcast Sportsnet. For a little preview of Bears Packers on Sunday night. Bears. Boy, what a huge game, partner.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Are you going to stay here to watch the preview and hitchhike down to St. Louis tomorrow? Here's Kane with a shot. Fought off by Varlamov.
Only if you're coming with me.
I'm going to take the plane. Much as I would like to get the game preview, I...
We'll send it to you email. How's that?
I love it. I have heard of that. Here's Kruger, who had a shot blocked to Smith. Kruger opted to Seabrook, a quick wrister into the glove of Varlamov. We are halfway through period three. The Hawks are up 5. During each Blackhawks game, visit the homepage of ChicagoBlackhawks.com and click on to the BMO Harris Bank Ice Tracker to monitor the game from your computer and mobile device. With real-time stats, play-by-play, photos, and more, visit ChicagoBlackhawks.com for more info. Well, the Blackhawks are half a period away from their 27th win of the year. And when that happens, they will move a point ahead of Anaheim for the NHL lead. The Ducks are not playing tonight, so Hawks will be a point ahead, but the Ducks would have a game in hand. And as Eddie mentioned earlier, this would give the Blackhawks a 7-point lead over St. Louis, but 4 games in hand for the Blues. And that'll be a huge get-together tomorrow night in St. Louis. Here's Kruger. Seabrook able to keep it in. Now Smith down low. Was able to win the puck, however, and out they come. Landeskog to Parenteau. Gabriel Landeskog. Mentioned the youngest captain in the league when he was named. The Avalanche captain before last year. He was the youngest guy to have ever been named the captain of any team. Even he was a few days younger than Sidney Crosby when Sid the Kid was named the Pittsburgh captain. Here's a breakaway for Taves, looking for his fourth hat trick. And a save by Varlamov.
What a pass from Seabrook.
Here's MacKinnon. Good stick there by Hjalmarsson. Now it came back in front. MacKinnon well covered. Hossa comes out. Marian Hossa gets the zone. Left it for Taves. He's got two goals, two assists. Now Sharp with 3-1. Got it to Hjalmarsson, who's got two helpers. Finally, the Avs. Duchesne moved it ahead. Barry dumped it. Oduya taking a look. And Bickle with a neat reception while being checked. Shaw's with him. Oh, and he wanted to get it to Andrew Shaw. Didn't work out. Comes back to Saad.
Good stick from Hayda there.
And now Bickle, helped by Roosevelt. Oops. Back comes Talbot. Tees it up. Shooting. Oh, did that hit the head? Here sounded like the face mask of Ranta. But he made the stop. We play on as McGinn. His pass went off a skate. And Saad able to get it out.
Oh, heavy shot there from Maxime Talbot. To the giveaway there from Michael Roosevelt at his own blue line.
Here's Versteeg. Leaving for Kane. It escaped him and... Well, the ass failed to clear. Kane back towards the middle. His stick was checked. Keith unable to make a play. Duncan Keith, who's got three assists in the game. Now Wilson, his pass broken up. Finally winds up with McLeod. Then Bortolo. Clouds long one missed. Patrick Bortolo put it in behind to Cody McLeod, who tried a wraparound that was blocked by Seabrook's stick. McLeod couldn't get it around the other post either, and Hanzus starts back. Hawks in need of a change here. Hjalmarsson up ahead to Bolig, and then Kruger comes away. Oduya's with him, and taken by Sharp. That's offside. With 5.5 remaining in the game, the Hawks in a runaway.
Well, Monday it's a rematch of the 2013 Western Conference Finals. Hawks and Kings. Coverage begins at 6:30 with Chevy. Blackhawks pregame live with host Pat Boyle. Hawks Kings Monday night at Comcast Sportsnet. Well, John Slobotkin, the man in the wine-colored sweatshirt, is the VP and executive producer of live events for Comcast Sportsnet, is here with his son Neil and his brother Andy.
Bolig gets to the corner, tried to center. is able to hack it free. Jan Hayda. Able to Eric Johnson. And this one is dumped in. Keith back. To center where Smith ran out of room, but Kruger pounds it in. Landeskog to Stasny, his pass missed Parento. A corner battle is taken by the Hawks. Out comes Sharp. Ahead for Hossa. Sharp, Ronce Toews. Oh, he nearly beat a check at the last moment. The puck rolled free. And back comes Hossa. Toews drives in. Toews to the backhand and a save by Varlamov. Rebound to Hossa. He's looking back towards Toews, but well covered that time, and the Avs clear it the other way for icing.
Well, time now for our KFC fan cam.
Here's Brandon Saad dropping it back. Roosevelt couldn't find a lane. Now Shaw in behind for Saad. Brandon Saad spins to his forehand and a long clip shot. Hit Varlamov, rebound to Shaw. He hit the side of the goal with a stop attempt. Held in Roosevelt for Shaw. Now Saad. Again to Shaw, checked by Duchesne. Duchesne scooped it to center ice.
Good strength there from Bickel in the middle of the ice.
Roosevelt's pass broken up. And down to 3 minutes left. Three goals in the game for Patrick Sharp. Two goals in the game for Jonathan Toews. Singles from Michael Hanzus and Chris Versteeg. The Avalanche goals have come from Stasny and Landeskog. Kane settles down a bouncer, put it in front for Versteeg. Oh, and he ripped a one-timer just wide.
Great reception from Kane off that pass, the aerial pass there from Versteeg. Knocked it right out of mid-air pad and able to settle it down, find Versteeg in that soft little area. I'm going to try it again.
Versteeg to Hanzus, looking towards Kane. Now Versteeg. He'll chip it in behind for Kane. Kane left it. Roosevelt joins the play, then Hanzus. To Letty.
How the game started, Pat, with Roosevelt jumping into the play down low.
Here's Letty with a long shot. Deflected just wide by Versteeg. And another shift by the Hanzus line where the F barely touched the puck. And penalty coming up against the Hawks. This pass missing. And the whistle goes with 81 seconds left.
Chicago number 32.
Minor penalty for delay of game for violation of equipment.
Wow, they're giving Michael Roosevelt a penalty for a violation equipment, and I'm assuming only thing that I saw, Pat, was his jersey was tucked in.
Yeah.
Wow.
Patrick Waugh's going, really? You're going to give us that one now?
Yeah.
Here's Tyson Berry on the Colorado power play. Here's a long shot, Benoit. Good love save and a good one by Ranta with a minute to go.
From my understanding, Pat, is that the referee has the ability to be able to go ahead and give the player a warning. Now, I don't know if he's ever given a warning. There's Brent Seabrook. Exactly. That's exactly what I would be doing. Referee Mark Jonette. I mean, there you see the jersey. Now, at some point during this game, hit Jonette warned Michael Roosevelt? I'm not sure.
Right.
But I would say...
You would have to hope that happened.
Yeah, right, I mean. Right, exactly.
Otherwise, that's goofy. And try to go down low, Stasny. Left it there, then the return pass. Paul Stasny. Upped it back to Benoit. Berry trying, looking back door. They couldn't find a lane for Stasny. It chipped out in front over the stick of Landeskog. Oh, and Saad could not get that out. Berry with 20 left. This one jammed back by Smith. Avs back in. Centering attempt. Good. Hit by Roosevelt as he flattened Parenteau. And now it's jammed back to center by Saad. Penalty, Denver.
Could have gave Parenteau one as well for cross-checking Johnny Oduya. The penalty killing numbers gets a boost there, partner, after the shortened penalty kill because of the penalty to Tyson Berry.
Well, just need to put the puck in play, and this one will become official. The Hawks even up the season series against the Colorado Avalanche, who since they started the season 12-1, a spectacular start for Denver, but since then they've been basically a 500 team. And the record continues to improve for the Blackhawks and Antti Raanta, who now is 9-1-2. And the Hawks are 27-7-6. Our Lexus Pursuing Perfection player of the game tonight. A 4-point evening for the birthday boy, Patrick Sharp, turning 32 today. He has 3 goals and an assist. And the assist might even be more spectacular than the goals because he stopped the breakaway, then fired it up the ice to send Johnny Taves into the other end where he scored. But Sharp raising his season total to 21. And here's the defensive play we talked about. That could have been a breakaway that Sharp stripped the puck free without getting a penalty and sent Taves to the other end. So a spectacular night for the Hawks number 10. So a bunch of happy humans leaving the UC tonight. Let's check out the 3-star selection.
It's time to announce tonight's 3 stars of the game, brought to you by Bud Light. The number 3 star of the game from the Blackhawks with 3 assists. Number 2, Duncan Keith. The number 2 star of the game from the Blackhawks with 2 goals and 2 assists. Number 19, Jonathan Taves. And the number 1 star of the game from the Blackhawks with the hat trick and 1 assist. Number 10, Patrick Sharp. Please turn your attention to the Blackhawks bench where Luke Stuckmeyer is with tonight's number 1 star of the game, Patrick Sharp.
Patrick, happy birthday. The first Blackhawk ever with a hat trick on his birthday. Will this quiet the kids in the dressing room?
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you. The guys were giving me some heat about turning 32 years old, saying I was an old man, so I had to go out there and prove them wrong.
After you scored three goals, you had the sweet back check to stop the breakaway, and you led to a Taves goal at the other end. How much pride does everybody in that dressing room take on the defensive side of the game?
Well, I know we get credit for scoring goals and making plays, but the reason we're a successful team right now is because we play well in all three zones, and that was just a lucky play where it was the right situation. I got my stick on it.
10-1-1 in the second game of back-to-backs this season. What's the key to being so successful when you play that second game? You've got a big one tomorrow.
Yeah, it's going to be a fun game tomorrow. We're getting excited for it. Tough place to play. I wish I had the answer, but we want to make sure we give our best effort. If I could just say hello to my parents up there. They made it in for my birthday, and I just got a hat trick for them. So thanks, guys.
Happy birthday, Patrick Sharp. 4 points on his birthday and a hat trick.
All right, that's the story from West Madison Street tonight for our terrific CSN crew and for Eddie Olczyk, Pat Foley, hoping you enjoyed the broadcast. We know you enjoyed the outcome. The Hawks 7 and the Avs 2. We'll see you again tomorrow night from St. Louis. Stay with us now. The Hawk Ford postgame show is coming up. Pat and Steve are all teed up for that one.
What a game for the Blackhawks. Thorough domination over the Colorado Avalanche. 7-2 the final. Big night for Patrick Sharp, the birthday boy. But this was set early on. That first shift, they set the tone.
They really did. And it wasn't just the first shift. It was the next three shifts thereafter. But those first shifts, always so important. And you're right. You know, they got it into Colorado's zone. They really dominated, and they took it to that team.
And it was the top line of Hossa, Taves, and Sharp. They were the number one stars going into the Christmas break. And they picked up right where they left off there the first period tonight.
Yeah, here it is. You get it deep, and you get it back. And that was their MO all night long. Jonathan Taves first to the puck. Then they move it around the perimeter. Great rotation from the defenseman. A wide open net for Jonathan Taves. He puts it a little wide. You know, that's literally 40 seconds into this contest. And as I mentioned, the next three shift after this in Colorado zone. So real important to get a good first shift under your belt, and that's exactly what they did.
Great pass. Great recognition there by Sharp. He's going to go off for the change, decided to stay on, and dunks hit him.
Yeah, that's the thing. It was the end of his shift. It was also the end of Jan Hayda's shift, and it was Patrick Sharp with the great speed there. And as you mentioned, just a really hard pass, and it had to be a hard pass from Duncan Keith. It sprung him for the partial break.
And it comes at a great time for Patrick Sharp as well, because that first week in January, Team Canada is going to announce who will be in Sochi for the Olympics, and that certainly improved his stock.
Well, I think so, and we've seen that. You know, he had 2 goals the last game, 3 goals tonight, so that's 5 goals in the last 2 games, but it's his defense. I mean, here's a guy who's hard on the puck when he doesn't have it. He's a physical guy, too. I don't know if he was credited with any hits tonight, but he likes the physical aspect of playing, and I think he's a lock for Team Canada.
17 games this season, the Blackhawks have scored 5 or more goals. It's the gift that keeps on giving from the defending Stanley Cup champs. A lot to get to on Hawk Ford Postgame Live. It comes your way after the break.